pulmonary tuberculosis requires access to respiratory specimen. In adults, it's simple because they can bring up sputum and give it voluntarily. However, children often tend to swallow it and are not able to produce sputum at volition or command. This makes collection of respiratory specimen little difficult in children. How does one access specimen in children with these difficulties? There are two ways it can be done. One way is by inducing sputum and collecting it through nasopharynx, or the other way is to collect it through the gastric aspirate. The first method, which is called induction of sputum, is largely used for children who either are not producing any sputum or are very young and are swallowing it up. In this situation, we prime them with a dose of salbutamol and follow it up with a 3% hypertonic saline nebulization. Priming is necessitated because 3% hypertonic saline can provoke bronchoconstriction in some children. To avoid that, we give them salbutamol either by nebulization or by MDI with spacer. After initial priming with salbutamol, 3% hypertonic saline is given by nebulization. This stimulates production of secretions in the respiratory passages. An older child may be able to cough out these loosened secretions on its own during the process of 3% hypertonic saline nebulization, while a younger child may need further assistance. For loosening up these secretions, in a younger child, one may have to do chest percussion. Even after chest percussion, a younger child, when he coughs up the sputum, will tend to swallow it. So how does one trap these secretions before they are swallowed by the child? One way to do it is to use a suction trap attached to either a suction machine or a wall suction port. The suction trap, when it is introduced into the nasopharynx of the child, stimulates cough. So as the loosened secretions come into the nasopharynx, before the child has a chance to swallow it, it is trapped by the suction and collected in the suction trap. This way, one can access the loosened secretion after inducing them with hypertonic saline.
Explain the procedure and take consent from the parent or guardian. Patient should be fasting for 2 to 3 hours prior to collection procedure. Instruments required for the procedure are disposable gloves, hypertonic 3% saline, syringe 10 ml size, needle, adhesive tape, sterile specimen container, sterile gauze cotton, nebulization chamber with oxygen tubing and mask, salbutamol, and mucus extractor or suction trap. Procedure should be performed in a well-ventilated room, having an exhaust fan, while wearing a N95 face mask. Baseline values of respiratory rate, pulse rate, chest retractions, Vs, and oxygen saturation should be taken prior to the procedure. Priming with salbutamol can either be done through metered dose inhaler, that is MDI, or nebulization using either respiratory solution or respule. MDI has an advantage that it takes less time and is as effective as nebulization. However, nebulization facility is essential to give 3% hypertonic saline. Instruments required for this procedure are inhaler and spacer. A mask is attached to spacer in case of a young child. Salbutamol is administered by sequentially giving 2 puffs, that is 100 micrograms through MDI with a spacer. This prevents bronchospasm from 3% hypertonic saline nebulization in children predisposed to it. Alternatively, administer salbutamol by nebulization using respiratory solution or respule. The neb respirator solution contains 5 mg of salbutamol per ml. The dosage for administration is 0.15 mg per kg. Taking age into consideration, the administered dosage varies as shown on the screen. For neb respule, use equivalent doses as respirator solution. Fill up the required amount of salbutamol from respiratory solution or respule. Load the drug formulation to the nebulization chamber. Add saline if required to ensure that volume of formulation in the chamber is above its minimal fill volume as shown. The next step is to nebulize with 5 ml of 3% sterile hypertonic saline. Use a sterile, commercially available preparation. Nebulization can be done through a jet nebulizer attached to pressured oxygen or air supply at the lowest flow rate needed to produce adequate mist, which usually is 5 to 7 liters per minute. While the child is being nebulized, give a container to the child to collect any expectorated sputum. As evident, this child has started expectorating while being nebulized with 3% saline. If the sample is adequate, then the procedure may be wrapped here and expectoration may be sent to lab for further processing. The characteristics of good sputum specimen are: desirable quantity of 3 to 5 ml, presence of mucoid or mucopurulent material, color varies from opaque white to green, should be brought up from inside the chest by a deep cough and should not be oropharyngeal secretion or saliva. Few children will only produce or bring up saliva or no expectoration on their own after 3% hypertonic saline nebulization. In such situations, one can loosen up secretions and assist child in secreting sputum by chest percussion. The purpose of chest percussion is to bring the secretions from the peripheral to central airways, from where the child can cough out the secretions. Palm of the hands while doing percussion should be made into a cup shape formed by the fingers and the thumb instead of a flat open hand. This avoids hurting the child. For younger children, it is ideal to percuss with fingers. Movement while percussion should be at the wrist and not elbow or shoulder. For percussion, we must cover all areas of chest in sitting, supine, and prone positions. If there is sputum production and child can expectorate, collect the sputum in sterile container. If still child is unable to expectorate or if it is a young child who needs assistance to collect secretions, then sputum can be collected by suction through nasopharynx or oropharynx. Use sterile mucus extractor or suction trap with the other end of the extractor connected to gentle suction of around 100 cm of water. The catheter is inserted through the nose. The length of the tube to be inserted is measured from side of the nose to the angle of the mandible. Apply lubricant jelly or wet the tube. A few children get scared, however, this procedure is not painful as evident in another patient. The catheter is gently inserted into the nose in a direction perpendicular to the face. Release suction. As the catheter touches the posterior pharyngeal wall, it can provoke cough. The loosened secretions are brought up with the cough and suction will facilitate its collection in mucus extractor or suction trap. In this child, as you can see, respiratory secretions have been collected. This should be immediately transported to Gene Expert lab. Monitor for 30 minutes after the procedure for respiratory complaints like respiratory rate, pulse rate, chest retractions, wheeze, etc. Fresh, sterile, disposable tubing and chamber for nebulization should be used for each patient. So, you learned that for induction of sputum, first step is to prime with salbutamol either by using MDI or nebulization using respiratory solution or respule, followed by nebulization with 3% hypertonic saline. If no expectoration, chest wall percussion is done. If still no expectoration, collect sputum by suction through nasopharynx or oropharynx. 50 ml conical tube is another type of container which can be used for sample transport instead of the disposable container shown in the video. As conical tube can be put directly into centrifuge machine, it is preferred when the sample is to be subjected to mycobacterial culture and drug sensitivity. This is also the preferred container for samples being sent to national TB program labs, as it does away the need to transfer the specimen from one container to another.